is Kristin, and I've been at Craig almost 10 years. My routine would be to come in, get all my papers together, get reports, just how we work as an interdisciplinary team all together. I've never experienced that anywhere else.
Oh, okay.
I look at all their class schedules, and that kind of determines how my morning will go. I love our TBI patients. That's why I'm on this floor. They can be anywhere from oriented times four, meaning they know where they are, they know why they're here, all the way to really just having no idea why they're here. Whoever has the first class, I get to wake up first. That takes till about 9:30 to do all your morning meds.
I'm gonna listen to you real quick and I'll let you get back to front of us.
It's about time for huddle at that point.
We just wanted to kind of connect up with some things for our huddle today.
But it needs to be on a part where it can't slide up and down.
We're doing the pilot program with Dr. Brubaker's team on BI and then Dr. Berliner's team on SCI.
Thanks for coming, guys.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Afternoon med pass, that's when I get to see patients again. Check in with them, how their classes went, what they went over in classes, so that we can reinforce that education.
So I do have some good news.
All the patients have, for the most part, a nurse for 12 straight hours, and then the nurse at night goes for another 12 straight hours. I couldn't ask for a better team. Everyone is just such a good team player. The doctors are so involved. They come in round with us every single day. They sit down with us and check in about every single patient. The nurses are obviously with them a lot more of the day than the doctors are able to because they have so many patients. So they really depend on us to really update them and tell the doctor how they're doing and what kind of changes need to be done. And then 6:30, the night shift will come in and we'll do a report with the night shift nurses from 6:30 to 7. I would say the most rewarding part of my job is just seeing the improvements of our patients. They'll come in and maybe not be able to talk or feed themselves or dress themselves, not be able to do anything for themselves. And the resilience of our patients and our family is unbelievable. When they get here, I always feel like we just wrap our arms around them as an entire team and we say, this really terrible thing happened to you, but we're gonna help you through it and we're gonna help you become as independent as you can.